This is section 3.5 on logistic growth. Bacteria. The growth of a culture of bacteria is shown in the table. Use exponential regression to model the data. Then use your model to predict how many bacteria there will be after 24 hours. So we have the hours listed in what would be the x coordinate, and we have bacteria listed in what we would consider the y column. And we're going to put the x's into our calculator into L1, and we'll put the y values into L2. So let's do that. Let's grab our calculator. We'll move it over. And let's get out of this. We go to stats, and we're going to get back into it. And we're going to go to edit. We're going to edit the lists. And we'll put the x coordinates in L1. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then we'll put the y values into L2. We have 400, 475, 565, 670, 800, 950, and 1130. Now we can plot these values. You can go to your graph, actually y equals, and you can actually turn the plot one on. And if you've had this on in the past, sometimes it gives you an error. But now we actually want to turn it on. And let's set our window from, let's say, 0 to, I don't know, 7, because we're going to 6. We go by 1s, and then how about we go from, let's say, 300 to 1,200, and we can go by hundreds on the y. Now, when we graph these, it gives us the points. It plots all the points, and we can see that it fits the curve of an exponential function. So we're going to do what's called exponential regression. In other words, we're going to let the calculator try to fit an exponential function to these points. So we'll go back into stats, and we're going to calculate. We're going to calculate an exponential regression formula. There's exponential regression, and let's just press enter. Well, now it's telling us that we have the function. We have the exponential function. We have y equals, and we have 400 for the a, or let's go, how about we go 399.57, and then our base is 1.189, so times 1.189 to the x. Let's type that into the calculator. We have 399.57, and that's times 1.189 raised to the x power. And this curve is supposed to fit our points closely. So we graph and we see that the curve estimates those points rather well. It's kind of starting to miss right here a little bit more than it does down at the bottom. Now it says then use your model to predict how many bacteria there will be after 24 hours. We can go back to our home screen and type 399.57 times 1.189 raised to the 24th power. And we get 25,465 bacteria. Memory. A group of students studied a photograph for 30 seconds. Beginning one day later, a test was given each day to test their memory of the photograph. The average score for each day is shown in the table. Use logarithmic regression to model the data, then use your model to predict the average test scores after 2 weeks. Let's go back into stat, and we will edit, and we can delete these values. Delete, keep deleting, delete, delete, delete. And go over here and delete all the X's. Actually, I could have left those, and we'll delete them. 1, 2, 3. We have 60.5 and 58.3. And we have our stat already on. Let's go to y equals. Let's clear this equation. And now we're going from 1 to 7. So 0 to, let's go a little bit outside of it. How about 0 to 8? And we can go from 70, how about 70 to, actually, the lowest value here is 58. So let's go 50. Let's see what's our highest value. Our highest value is in the 70s, so maybe we go to 80, and we can go by fives there. So let's graph it. This is the shape of a log function, except it's been reflected over the x-axis, because normally the log function looks like this shape right here, but this one's been turned upside down. Let's see if that that happens with the numbers that we get when we do a logarithmic regression. So we'll go to stats, and now we will calculate, not one variable. Let's go to stat. We are calculating a logarithmic, so let's find the log. Here's natural log, and let's calculate. Well, now the equation is y equals a plus b ln x. The a is 73.092, so y equals 73.092, and then minus, if I remember right, because that's negative, 7.313 natural log of x. And use your model to predict the average test score after 2 weeks. Well, this is 7 days, so now we need to plug 14 in for x. So let's go to our calculator. We can go back, well, we are in the home screen. We got 73.092 minus 7.313 times the natural log of 14 days. And we get 53.8%. Exponential growth is unrestricted. An exponential growth function increases at an ever-increasing rate and is not bounded above. In many growth situations, however, there is a limit to the possible growth. A plant can only grow so tall. The number of goldfish in an aquarium is limited by the size of the aquarium. In such situations, the growth often begins in an exponential manner, but the growth eventually slows and the graph levels out. Now, what they're saying is if you have a pure exponential function, like y equals e to the x, that goes up very quickly and it shoots off to infinity. But that's not really realistic for growth. A better one is the logistic growth function. It starts out reasonable, grows exponentially, but then it starts to level off. So these are the logistic growth functions here. Let a, b, c, and k be positive constants with b less than 1. A logistic growth function in x is a function that can be written in the form c over 1 plus a times b to the x, or c over 1 plus a times e to the negative kx, where the constant c is the limit to growth. Logistic growth function has the form where t is any real number, a, b, and c are positive constants, and c is the limit to growth. So here's the shape of a logistic function, and it does start out growing exponentially, but then it's going to level off due to circumstances. Like, you can't have 5 billion fish in a pond. There's just not going to be enough room, enough food, enough oxygen. So there's going to be a limit to the growth of, let's say, fish in a pond. The logistic function, 1 over 1 plus e to the negative x, is the parent function. And it crosses through 0.5, and it eventually levels out to 1. The domain is all reals. The range is 0 to 1. It's continuous and increases for all x. There is symmetry about 0.1 half, but neither even nor odd. Bounded below and above, there's no local extrema. We have horizontal asymptotes at y equals 0. You can't have less than 0 fish. And y equals 1. No vertical asymptotes. And the end behavior is going to the left, going to the right, it levels out to 1. Going to the left, it levels out to 0. Population of Aurora, Colorado. Years after 1950, and we have the population. Use logistic regression to find a logistic curve to model the data and superimpose it on a scatter plot of population against years after 1950. So let's open up our calculator. We'll type this into L1 and L2. So we want to edit. We can delete all these. 5923 and 290418. Well, now with our window, we should have 0 to, let's say, 60. and maybe we go by fives. And then we have to go from 10,000 to, let's say, 300,000. And maybe we go by 10,000. Let's graph this. And it's starting to exponentially grow, and it's kind of leveling off. Go to stat, we want to calculate, and we have to go to logistic regression. Here's the logistic, and it should give us the equation. So for letter A, we have y equals 316,440.713 divided by 1 plus, we have the A, which is 23.577, and then e to the negative 0.10256x. Let's plug that into y equals. We have 316,440.713 divided by parentheses 1 plus 23.577 and then times e to the negative 0.10256x. Let's press enter and we'll graph and see how close it follows the points. Pretty close. Based on the regression equation, what will the Aurora population approach in the long run? So in other words, what is this leveling out to? And it's leveling out to the 316,440. So 316,440. Based on the regression equation, when will the population of Aurora first exceed 300,000 people? Let's go to y equals. Let's set y2 equal to 300,000. And then we can find the intersections of these two graphs right here. So we have, we can go second, calculate. We want intersection. And we have first curve, second curve, and we need to make a guess. So I'm going to right click over to where it looks like they're intersecting and press enter. So 59.129, that's going to be years. And if we add that to 1950, then we have in the year 2009. The number of television ads for a certain product affects the percentage of people who purchase the product as shown in the table. Use logistic regression to find a logistic growth function to model the data. Then use your model to predict the limit to the percentage of people who will purchase the product. Well, let's go to stat and we're going to edit. We can clear these out. Actually, we want to delete these out. Let's press enter and delete all of these out. 37.8 and then 49. And we're going to use the model. So let's just go to regression. We can go to stat, calculate, and we want logistic. And we will get the formula over here. We have y equals. Well, we're just predicting the limit to the percentage of people, and c is the top percentage. So there's your limit right there, 53.694%.